Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a BMW 3 Series E90, 91, 92, 93 generation 2005 to 2013. That video will work for all 3 Series that generation guys, and we'll show you how to remove or how to replace the center vents. If yours are not working, okay, if the flaps are not working or something, we'll show you guys how to do that, how to remove and replace them. In the meantime, we'll have more than 200 videos uploaded on this car, so if you need help with anything, please guys, subscribe to the channel, okay? And if you need help, drop a comment, we'll try to make that video for you. So, let's start on it now. So, all the tools guys and parts that we use will be listed in the description of the video below. Check it out, that's for your convenience. So let's start on it now. First, okay, we need to get prying tools, panel, plastic panel removal tools. Okay, I have a couple here that I'll be using today. And usually if you come right here, okay, just saw some glue here. Okay, come right here underneath. Okay, you have to be very gentle how you push, because if you push too much, okay, let me show you what could happen. You can crack your wood. Okay, you can see how somebody cracked it here. That's because when it was removed. And now I'll get the other two and gently, okay, start prying the clips out. Okay, came out on this side. Okay, now let's see on top. A few here. You have to kind of like pull on it a little bit at the same time. Okay, to be careful not to cause any damage to the dash. A little bit stuck on this side. Okay, it looks like it has a clip right here in the corner, holding really, really tight. Okay, it came out. Now, right here in the middle, you have two wires that you will need to disconnect. Okay, and let me see if I can get enough light here. First, you need to disconnect the ignition switch wire. Okay, the one right here. So press down right here on these two. Pull it out. Okay, just like that. Now we have wires underneath, and we need to flip it the other way now. Okay, to disconnect them. Okay, so with a small flathead screwdriver, we're gently prying this wire out. It has one tooth holding in place. And after that, we have one more wire that we need to figure out how to reach now. And now that switch guys, if you cannot reach the wires, actually the correct way, we just figured it out, is if you grab the switch from the inside with your hand, push on it really hard, it's going to come out. Okay, so you can disconnect the wire like that now. Okay, just like that. So practically you can remove the switch without removing the thing, but there is a possibility you're going to break a vent or the switch. So we will recommend to remove it first, so you can grab your you can grab it with your fingers from behind and push it out, because it has two clips, okay, on top and two on bottom. So that whole piece now will come out. Okay, gently we just pull everything out. So in order to remove the center vent, we need 8mm socket. Now we have one nut here that we'll need to remove, and after that Okay, we have one nut on this side. Okay, just like that. Now all those clips on the bottom side, okay, we have to start prying up a little bit, but do not apply too much pressure because, okay, it will break. One person need to pull up on it a little bit and one person need to release the clips. Okay, still holding a little bit here and there. You can see it got loose on this side. Now we have some on top. Okay, let's see how we're going to slide it out. So those are the same way like the bottom ones. You have to gently push up and pry them open. Okay, you can see they pop out. Okay, it's almost out. I think it's moving. Just the last one holding there. Okay, and you can see the center vents came out. So, this is the center dash vent. When you're ready to get the replacement one and install it, you need to just get it in, push it all the way in. Everything has to be lining up perfectly. All the clips need to click in place. Okay, ours, you can see it needs to go this way because we didn't pay attention how we installed it. Okay, so we'll get it out and reposition it again. Okay, you can hear that click, that's what we need. And after that, all we have to do is install the two nuts, get those tight, and installation of the trim piece will be in reverse order that we took it apart. So thank you guys for watching, please subscribe and many more videos to come.